You are all set up for your New Year's Eve celebration, so let me wish you also. And what better setting than this, outdoors on a bright, beautiful, sunny winter day in Delhi. It's a blessing, winter day with no smog, beautiful air quality as well. Those are rare days. So I do hope that we have a sunny, beautiful, safe year going ahead in 2022 also. Now, a lot of you have been complaining that we've not been sharing outdoor locations with you, or you've been missing our outdoor settings, flowers, birds chirping, aircraft noise, right, traffic noise, stuff like that, and sometimes the odd piece of terracotta. Now, this was something that was forced on us last year because of the work from home situation. So we were working from home and mostly from outdoors, because you know why? While working from home is safer, working outdoors is even safer. So that's what started like that. And we thought for a while, the producer also complained that sometimes there were audio glitches and also there was a lot of audio disruptions and noises. But I have to say that all of you were forgiving, so thank you very much. And certainly nobody minds bird song that almost always accompanies our outdoor shoots. Now, having said that, I thought I will do the concluding Cut the Clutter of the Year outdoors as well, just to revisit many of those locations. Also, it's a very special episode or edition of Cut the Clutter, where we are talking not just about Cut the Clutter, but Cut the Clutter and National Interest. So we have picked out the 10 most seen, most watched Cut the Clutter and National Interest videos. Now, through those, we also understand what have been the concerns on our mind. Now, I could have started this, in fact, this whole preamble on a slightly more sobering or maybe even negative note by saying, see, life has turned full circle. We were forced to work outdoors and at home last year. It looks like we are heading in the same direction now with Omicron rising. But let's not take a pessimistic view. Let's take an optimistic view, because this year, when COVID is making a return, we have multiple vaccines. A lot of us are vaccinated. Those who aren't should immediately, quickly get vaccinated, because vaccinations will save lives. Already data from Europe, South Africa, America, everywhere is telling us that vaccinated people are much less likely to develop severe infections, even if Omicron can break through their immunity. So this is a lot more optimistic note than it would have been at this time last year or through most of the year. But also see what have we done through the year, and that is very instructive. See, for example, in the year, we've talked about national politics, that's our staple, roti, dal or dal chawal or dahi chawal, whatever you want to call it. National politics, COVID, China, Pakistan. Then we also delved into other foreign issues. For example, America, of course, a lot, but Russia, quite a bit of Russia. Thank Putin for that, right? Putin, Ukraine. The whole year looks like a blur in which we also crossed into many new frontiers. We talked about Chile, Venezuela, Brazil, Taiwan, many times Middle East, and of course, we discovered new parts of the world, Japan, new parts of the world in which we never thought we Indians were so interested. But it also told me that we Indians are now truly international people with international minds, and our media by and large is much too inward looking and is not giving us too much of this international interesting stuff that we are curious about. National politics, a lot. Farmers' protests and farm law controversies, a lot, including the capitulation by the Modi government in the end, which we had foreseen last year in January, and we had said that this was coming, that Modi government had lost the farm battle. That in spite of the fact that I am a pakka, diehard, unabashed supporter of the new farm laws, and I regret deeply that these farm laws have been lost for now. So at some point, not just now, but at some point, I will also share with you an abridged version of the long Cut the Clutter episode I had done when the farm laws were passed, saying why these were welcome and why these were good. Because I'm still hoping that while the laws right now are buried, a lot of the ideas in the laws will now be implemented through consensus and through negotiation, because that's an important thing. So here are the rankings of the 10 this year. The most seen by far, by a long distance. The most seen means seen more than 3 times the number 2. That was how scientists across the world were shaken by revelations or by indications that coronavirus may have actually escaped from China. Now, in the year, we did 252 episodes of Cut the Clutter, not including this one, 252. And also, we did nearly 50 national interest articles, also accompanied by videos. So I will give you a broad breakup of those, and that will give you an idea of how this year went by. But before I do that, I will also tell you of a companion I have had very often, and sometimes you've seen him walking up and down our parapet of the terrace of our home. That is our dearest Denzel, our cat at home. We have many cats around the house that are friends of ours. We look after them, but Denzel is the one who spends the most time with us and who's inside the house. So please meet Mr. Denzel, who's been my constant companion through these months of the lockdown and working from home. And once again, I think he was quite happy. One, that was a bright sunny day. And second, because he figured that I was again back to working from the terrace. So he's also back to work with us. Anyway, so if you look at a broader split of what we have done this year. So of this 252 Cut the Clutters, 45 were on politics, right? That's our staple. Now, when I say politics, mostly Indian politics, but there are some about international politics that we have also included here. For example, Nepal had political upheavals and changes. Israel had many political upheavals and changes. It's multiple elections, and we understood how the proportionate representation system works. Thanks to them, there was Iran, Germany, both had elections and both had politics. So we are putting them in the larger political basket. Then there is coronavirus, COVID, 34 episodes. That is almost as many as politics, national and international in the year. So we also remember, now it looks like a blur, it feels like a blur, but the fact is that we went past the second devastating wave of COVID in these 12 months in 2021. And now it looks like we are getting back into another cycle, for which hopefully we are much better equipped. So 34 on coronavirus. In fact, sometimes I even called it Cut the Corona Clutter, right? Particularly we did some parallel ones in Hindi, जिसको हमने बोला कट द कोरोना क्लटर, बिकॉज वी थॉट कि इतनी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है कोरोना वायरस के ऊपर और नॉलेज कि वो हिंदी में जितनी ऑडियंसिस को जा सके. आई विश आई कुड डू इट इन तमिल एंड मलयालम एंड तेलुगू एंड गुजराती एंड मराठी एंड बंगाली एज वेल, बट आई डोंट हैव दो स्किल्स. फॉर दैट यू नीड समवन लाइक नरसिम्हा राव, हु आई बिलीव कुड स्पीक मे बी 9 or 12 or 15 languages, गॉड नोज how many. I haven't got those talents, so I do the best I can, which is when possible and when there is time, I also do something in Hindi. Now, other subjects, and there were some interesting pointers and surprises. Northeast this year had 5 episodes of Cut the Clutter, 5. That also shows that we have special affection for the Northeast, and also because Northeast is ignored by a lot of our media. Also, I have to thank you all for watching these very well. We were making no sacrifice on the numbers, watchability, advertising. These were watched as much as any other. So all of India is interested in the Northeast. That is a wonderful thing. So thank you very much. China, 26. Importantly, Pakistan, 17. So this also reflects the fact that now we are thinking a lot more about China, as we should have been doing all these years, than about Pakistan. So thank you Xi Jinping for making it possible by being such a pain on our northern and northwestern frontiers. Pakistan 17, I told you. Then another interesting thing that we added this year to Cut the Clutter was reports and rankings, because everybody got interested. Rankings on the Hunger Index, rankings on Press Freedom Index, rankings on Poverty Index, UN Development Goals, all of those. So 13 of our CTCs this year were about rankings and indices. Then international issues not involving India, Pakistan, US or China, or say US or China in the India context in any way. Do you know how many did we do this year? 31. And these are amongst our most watched. That also tells me that our viewers, readers are so much more international and global in their thinking that most of our media thinks. That is why you find foreign pages in our newspapers completely dying out, foreign coverage in most of our mainstream channels completely dying out, unless it's the US election or it is something that really concerns India, right? But my learning over this year from Cut the Clutter and National Interest and the response we've got from them is that far too many Indians are curious, they are hungry about news and knowledge and understanding of the world, and our media by and large is letting them down there, and that's a gap which I hope we are filling. We've also started a new product this year called World 360, which is a shorter, snappier bun, unlike my long harangues. And that's done by one of my youngest colleagues, Pia Krishnan Kutty. So please watch out for that. Now, other subjects. Afghanistan, you would expect. This was the year of the upheaval in Afghanistan. So 13 on Afghanistan, farm laws 2, law and judiciary 6, defense 9, USA and US politics 10, and very interestingly sports 6. And all of these were not about cricket. We talked about the Olympics, we talked about India's athletic performance, we talked about hockey as well. So that again is a good change. Now, national interest, 11 about politics, 6 about coronavirus, as you would expect. China 2, Pakistan just 1 in the whole year, that's good news. Rankings and reports 1, Northeast 2, the same logic as applies to Cut the Clutter. Afghanistan 4, law and judiciary 2, sports 2, and farm laws 3. Unfortunately, all three this year were talking about the failure of the Modi government to get the farmers to buy into the farm laws. And that is because of the manner in which these were rushed through an ordinance without a discussion in parliament, and also the way they were railroaded in Rajya Sabha, it gave everybody the impression that government was forcing something down their throat. And if that happens, nobody likes it. Now I will give you the rankings of this year's 10 top episodes, and I will also give you one or two lines of description for each one, and the reason why I think more of you might have watched these, but why don't we do that from some different spots? That is also to bring back the memory of what you may have seen in the course of the year. So now we are back to one of our favorite settings, which is in front of the bougainvillea bushes, even though this is not the season when they are in full bloom. So I will give you the list top 1 to 10. Our most seen video this year was a Cut the Clutter episode. And this Cut the Clutter episode was about how scientists across the world were shocked by revelations or by indications that coronavirus may have actually escaped from the Wuhan virology lab in China as a result of a gain of function research. So we learned a new expression, a new word in science, gain of function. Now remember, nothing has been proven on this as yet, but this has been a year almost since we did that episode, and the fact is that a full 2 years, in fact more than a full 2 years after the first COVID-19 was spotted, nobody has found out either the host animal, which animal did it came from, or the intermediate animal, which is which animal did it jump from to get into human beings. So this is very mysterious. The 2 years now, all of the world scientific community, this is a virus spread all over the world. Nobody has been able to find out where it came from. And there's a lot of skepticism about the kind of access China has given to researchers. And that's why I think the reason is that a lot more of you watched it. In fact, this has been seen almost 4 times as much as the second best of the year. And not surprisingly, our second most watched this year was also about the COVID crisis in the second wave, in the Delta wave, and that was a national interest. And that was this, Mayday, Mayday, how Modi government led India into a perfect storm. And that went back to how the government declared victory, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's speech at World Economic Forum, where he pretty much declared victory and he said India has now defeated COVID, and India will now help the world defeat COVID by exporting vaccines. And soon enough, we walked into this terrible, terrible, terrible storm, some of which was of our own making. Because if we had been less triumphal earlier, we could have been better prepared. We could have started, for example, our vaccination drive much earlier. Nevertheless, this was our second most seen. And not surprisingly, it also got the government very angry and got us a lot of attention. That wasn't very kind. But you know what? This is what unhyphenated journalism is all about. Because you have to go by facts and you have to let facts guide your opinion as well. Unhyphenated journalism is not neutral. There is no such thing as neutral journalism, right? Only robots can be neutral. Human beings can't be neutral, and any human being, particularly a journalist who says I'm neutral, is either lying or is a robot, right? So you take a position. The important thing is in good journalism, which we think is unhyphenated journalism, is that you get the facts and let those facts inform your opinion and analysis. That's what we try to do at The Print. And when you respond to it positively, we are very happy. When you respond to it in criticism or you point out to errors, I make many errors. Occasionally, I might get some names wrong, or sometimes I may mix up some facts. That's also because you know that I'm not speaking from a teleprompter. The closest thing I have to a teleprompter are these yellow sheets, which you are familiar with. And you know, I scribble things on these, like scribbling thoughts on my mind. But my handwriting is so bad that mostly even I am not able to read from these. So I do make some errors, and when you point those out, I am even more grateful than I am for your praise, and I correct them as soon as possible. So thank you very much for being vigilant and for keeping me honest when I slip up, because I am very happy to say sorry when I do so. The third most seen this year is also about coronavirus. It came out in the same period of the second wave of the pandemic, and this was headline foreign media on COVID crisis. What is foreign media saying on COVID crisis, and why is Modi government so upset about it? And the fact is, once again, we said that foreign media is reflecting the reality on the ground. And instead of being upset, Modi government, they should get their act together and do better in handling the pandemic. And once again, it did not endear us to the establishment, but that is the price we pay in the line of duty. Now, the next three, that is number 4, 5, and 6, also indicate how international we've become in our thinking. So the fourth is why Bajwa is signaling peace in Pakistan, but Imran Khan is blocking it. And once again, even the Cut the Clutter episode yesterday talked about how Imran Khan over the year has pushed back at the military establishment, and that has led to tensions within the Pakistani political system. So what was brilliantly described by Pakistani journalist, well-known Pakistani editor Nazim Sethi, as miltablishment, which was a kind of milibhagat, a kind of hybrid regime of the military and the elected government, etc. There are some cracks in that. And this article, I would say, had foreseen that coming, and that was our fourth most watched. Fifth, giant ship blocks Suez Canal. Remember that story? It was a Cut the Clutter. And when I did it, it made me read up a lot, understand a lot of things that I knew nothing about, particularly about shipping, Suez Canal, etc., etc. But I thought, even when I was doing it, I thought very few people will watch it. This will have marginal viewing. It just looked like one of those oddball stories, but it was watched by more than 500,000 people. That taught us, in fact, something about you viewers and readers in India, that you are now much more global in your thinking, that most of us journalists gave you credit for. Number 6 is once again international, Evergrande crisis. Remember Evergrande or Evergrande, however you pronounce it? That is a big real estate company in China that collapsed and left a lot of bad debt in its wake. So number 7 is about Air India sale to the Tatas. And immediately, so many of you latched on to the fact or locked on to the fact that this was a big turn in the thinking of India's global economy. It's a bit unfortunate that after that, some of the other promises on privatization, etc., have slowed down. It also looks quite evident that the promise of privatizing two of the PSU banks may not come about in this financial year. But the fact is, since I'm an optimist, I would say the direction is set. and somehow we'll get there. Although the closer you get to the general election, the next general election, the tougher it becomes. It's like a lot of these things have to be done in the power play overs, and the power play overs end early in politics. After that, then you are consolidating, and then you are desperate preparing to win the election. So let us see, let us hope this will not slow down, and after UP and other states elections, this process will pick up again. Number 8, we go global again. That was the Karta Clutteran AUKUS, A-U-K-U-S-S. That is the agreement, strategic agreement that Australia, US and UK signed, mainly leading towards the building of nuclear-powered submarines in Australia. So that was seen as a big indicator or a big nudge to China. A lot of you liked it, a lot of you watched it. Thank you very much. At number 9, we are back to the second wave of the pandemic, the Delta wave, where we said that because of its confusion and waffling and inadequate handling and complacence, Modi government had sort of given justification to those who had been describing India as a flailing state, those India skeptics. And once again, it caused a lot of irritation on the side of the establishment. But I think we were speaking the truth, and the truth has to be spoken. And finally, number 10 was our Karta Clutter on Tejas clearance. On what does the clearance of Tejas for purchase by Indian Air Force in large numbers mean for Indian domestic aircraft building industry, Indian domestic armament industry, on which there has been a lot of focus under Modi government. It's a welcome focus. It's a good thing. We also gave you a little information in history on the experience that Indian Air Force has had dealing with HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, on domestic aircraft manufacture in the past. Now, those of you of a particular vintage or those who are familiar with Hindi film music, you might remember Amin Sayani and Binaka Geetmala, because he used to do a countdown of the 13 most popular Hindi film songs of the week. So there are many differences here. First of all, I don't have the voice or the style or delivery of Amin Sayani. And second, more importantly, and let me make that confession before one of you points out, because I know that all of you are very questioning, very demanding, very irreverential. So let me myself make that admission, disclosure, confession, whatever you may call it, that unlike Amin Sayani, I am not doing a countdown on other people singing. All of this is a countdown of my own singing, unfortunately. So I apologize to you for that. Once again, a wonderful new year to you. May 2022 be a lot better than 21 has been. And all the very best to you and your families. Stay happy, stay healthy, and stay safe.